creative weapons. A little bit different here, okay? Creative weapons in terms of what you can do with your body, okay? Same as creative forms, okay? You can't kick past 360 degrees, and you can't do movements that cause you to be inverted. Okay, so creative weapons, you can't do it. Okay, so the distinction comes in with what you can do with your body. Now, in creative weapons, there are zero limitations to what you can do with the weapon. None. Okay, you can do anything in creative weapons. You can throw your bow staff up in the air. Okay, you can twirl it on your thumb. You can twirl it on your pinky. You can do anything. You can twirl it behind your back between your legs. You can throw it up. You can catch it. There are zero limitations to what you can do with the weapon in creative weapons. Okay, the limitations come in is with what you can do with your body. Okay, no flips. No kicks past 360, okay? So no 540s, no extreme movements, okay? But with the weapon, you can do anything, okay? Now, because you can do anything, guess what? You're gonna see anything, okay? You're gonna see kids throwing their weapon, you're gonna see kids twirling them, you're gonna see them spinning them, cutting fast. Again, it's not gonna be traditional, and it might not even have the same martial arts fundamental application that we might be used to, okay? But that's just the nature of the sport evolving, okay? Things change, things evolve. It's not for us to say we hate it or we don't like it or that's not how I learned it. It's just for us to embrace, okay, because it's here to stay, all right? And just to understand the differences so we can be effective judges, okay? Yes, sir.
So if you do drop your form, make sure that that's part of your form.
Right, absolutely. So in the rules, it states in black and white, okay, that you can't unintentionally drop your weapon. If you unintentionally drop your weapon, it's automatic no score, okay? So if you unintentionally drop your weapon, it's automatic no score. So that's just an important distinction, and that's true for all the divisions. Okay, so you cannot drop your weapon. Okay, from the white belts all the way up to the black belts, from the kids all the way up to the adults. Okay, and the reason why that we hold steadfast even in the underbelt divisions with the kids is because we want them to get used to, you know, having solid weapons manipulation, so they don't get used to dropping and starting over. Okay, Kaelyn, would you grab your sword? All right, again, creative weapons. You can do anything with the weapon. Okay, limitations come with what you can do with your body that you cannot do with your body. Okay, go ahead. Legal creative weapons, you can do that, okay? You can throw it up 10 times if you want to and catch it. Perfectly legal and creative weapons, limitations come with what you can do with your body, okay? No kicks past 360, no inverted techniques. A movement that you'll see commonly in the creative division is a wushu butterfly kick, okay? Head dips down, comes up, leg swing up, boom. Okay, you'll see that all the time. It's within the parameters of the rules. You can do that, okay? As long as you don't go past parallel. What you can do is you can do a wushu butterfly kick as long as the head goes up. Okay, because if the head goes up, then what's going to happen is your body's going to stay more or less parallel to the ground, which is within the parameters of the rules, okay? So, wushu butterfly kick, just so everyone kind of knows what we're talking about here. Just like that, okay? Now, shoot her do the same technique, but her head goes down, and her legs go up, okay? That becomes an extreme technique, okay? It becomes an inverted movement, okay? When I say inverted, legs over the head can't do that, okay? So, demonstrate the same thing, but I want to see an aerial. Okay, I actually want to see it there, so straight over the top. Okay, so did you see the distinction of the movement there? That would be an illegal technique.